There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Chris here, and I'm going to teach you how to make a basic shark rig that I've learned from Infinity Fishing Team. So yeah, all the credit goes to them, and I'll get started now. So first, you're gonna need your wire. This is like number 15 wire. Number 15 right there, 240 pound, and this is, I think it's around 300 feet, but whatever. 400 pound swivels, 400 pound thimbles, 400 pound crimps, 400 pound monoliter, pliers, crimper, some hooks. I use this to check the knots or the crimps. Instead of having to hold the swivel, I just put it through that. And here's some that I've made. This is just the mono, crimped with swivels and all that. But I'll make some new ones for you guys. I'll put that away. And here I've got two or three, or actually three, rigs, complete rigs that I've made. I'll show you the finished rig at the end. So yeah, let's get started. So first, you're gonna want around 10 feet of this 400 pound mono. I like 10. Some people do more, but I think that's just too much. So yeah, do 10, unwind this all, all that. Okay, so now I got 10 feet of this mono, and I'll just cut it, and that's all for mono. You don't need that anymore. Now you have to crimp it, and how you do that, get your crimps. I use four for each rig, so there's four. Put this away, you don't need that anymore. Now you got your four crimps right here, and you're gonna need two thimbles. There's two, and then you're gonna need two swivels. Okay, now this 400 pound mono is 1.8 millimeter, so I couldn't find 1.8 millimeter swivels, so I got 1.9, but they still fit pretty tight. Like, it's hard to put the line through it, so they work. So yeah, now they're in, or one is in. Slide that down about 5 to 10 inches, and then you put another one. Okay, then you get your thimble, put it through your swivel, and you press it down. You press it down, so you see how it's open. You press it down until it's closed, and now it's closed over the swivel. And then put your line through the swivel, not the thimble, just like that, through the swivel. Okay, then you put your line back through the crimp, the first crimp, and then it's through. Then scoot the second one back a little. So then tighten this up. Now when it gets when it gets pretty small, put your thimble in it, just like that. And you tighten it up until it's tight. And then now you crimp it. This is 1.9 millimeter, so you put it in between 1.0 and 2.0, right there. So yeah, crimp it. Crimp the other side. Okay. Now, the other crimp. And I always have this other crimp here, just in case anything goes wrong with the first one. So yeah, put that one through. I'm gonna have to recut this. There's a little bump up there. I can't put it through. Okay. Okay, your crimp is through. Both lines are through the crimp, just like that. Make sure there's no loop in here, like that. So when you crimp it, there's a loop. So make sure it's perfect. Okay, now that's ready to crimp. Crimp it. Okay. Other side. Crimp it. Then the middle. The two sides. And then that's it for that side. There you go. There's a little loop in there, but that's okay. That's just not too big. So yeah, crimp that right there. But then that one. And then the swivel right here. So yeah. I'm gonna get to the wire now. Okay, so I got the wire out and I cut 8 feet of the wire and then I double it over so it turns out to be 4 feet at the end. Yeah, I got the wire. Here's the 8 feet, whatever. So then you want to get a better angle at this. Kind of hard to do it with this one little camera, one little room. So yeah, you get them to be both ends like that, even, and then all the way you slide it down, and then you make it kink like that at the end, so you get it to the half of it, so it's kinked. Now you know where to cut it. Get your pliers or your snap, whatever you cut with this, and you cut it right there in the middle of that. There. Just cut it. So now I got 2 pieces of 4 feet wire, number 15 wire. And now what I do, I usually cut this because it's a little bent right there from the kink, so I just cut that off a little. Yeah, that's cut off. Go to this side and make sure it's perfectly even, which it is. Right there. So now, you take your swivel, 400 pound swivel, put it through. Leave around 5 to 6 inches of your doubled wire. And it's about 5 or 6, whatever. And you fold it like that. Whoops. Make it like a V. Okay, there's a V right there. So then, make sure the two wires are parallel to each other. If they're not, the knot will fail. I made it little smaller. So there. Now I'm gonna get this, hold the swivel, and bring both of the wires around. This is really hard to do it with not that much room and trying to record it. So yeah. So you bring it around just like that. So it looks like a fish kinda. And you fold it back like that. So that's where you start your twist. Okay, then you fold it so it's like a 90 degree angle right there. And use this like a handle. Flip your swivel just like that and use it like a handle. And twist your wire. And make sure it's always like at that 90 degree angle, like that. Facing straight up, and then same thing, twist your wire and wrap it tightly together, but make sure it doesn't overlap it each other. And I know it's hard not to. I mean, with the camera down here on the floor, it's pretty hard to do this on the little desk. So yeah, wrap it tightly together. Starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. Oh, the sky is on your head, my man. sizes you want. So yeah, I'm done with the twisting and all that. It didn't all come out as good as I wanted it to, but better than nothing. So now, let's bring this back to the desk. And now, you bend this wire, these two wires back and forth like this. All the way over here, all the way back, all the way over here.
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and tell me how that I lay or should be. See how I leave with every piece of you.
Oh yeah, and this one is done now, so boom, popped off. And there it is, right there. Whatever, you can't see it. But yeah, that knot is done with the swivel. Now, it's way easier when you have two people doing this, but since I have one right now, that's what I use this thing for. I loop it around this. It's like a D-hooker, homemade D-hooker, kind of. I loop it around right there, and then over here, on my feet, and I hold it, and then all the way up here, I twist this. I don't know if you can see this good, but it's going to have to do. I twist both wires. You twist them together. Doesn't matter which way you go. Don't do it hard so that they kink themselves. Just do it softly, like how I'm doing it. Back and forth, and just, yeah. And then, yeah. At the end, you want to leave around five or six inches of this extra wire, not twisted. So you can tie the knot, the other twist, if you know what I mean, on the hook. So there. I'm done twisting it, and I've got around six inches of this wire just parallel to each other. And then you get this hook. I'll have a description where you can buy these hooks. Or you can buy them from Infinity Fishing Team, because that's how I got this one. And thank you again, because they gave me that. So yeah, you want to do the V again. And bend it all the way back. Like that. This should be a little easier, since you already have the other knot, and the wire's not, like, dangling and all that. So yeah, you get it to that. Oh crap, came out of my hands. Make sure it's parallel. So you get it like that, and then you do that one twist right there, which starts it. Just like that. And then it's not going to go anywhere. Okay, and then, let's see, let's move some of this stuff, and then you get right here, and then do the same process as the last one. Twist, 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 twist. Now, where's my box? Gotta get the GoPro box, put the GoPro on the box, aim it down, and here we go. Use like the hook, as just like a handle, just like that, against the wire, and then you twist, make sure they're parallel. It's very important. Find is where I can find a place to go on. Show me the way, carry me home. Okay, so I just finished the knot on the hook of the doubled wire. Didn't come out the best, but it should hold. So yeah, I don't know if you can see it too good, but yeah. So yeah, it's about 3 or 4 feet of this wire doubled up. And there's the knot with the 400-pound swivel. So now, this part, you get the other end of your 400-pound mono, which is right here. You need to get the thimble, put it back through the swivel, just like I did before. Get the pliers, close the thimble so it's not open. Oh, bent a little. Okay, so I just closed it. And then you put your mono through the swivel, not the thimble, just like that. And then, oh no, wait, before you do that, you need to put your two crimps on. There's one crimp, slide it down so it's not in the way. Get the other crimp, slide it down. Okay, get the wire again with the swivel and the thimble on it. Put it through the swivel, like I just said a couple seconds ago, a couple minutes ago, whatever. And make sure the thimble is like that when you put it through. And then you put your mono through the crimp, if I can get it in here. I need to cut it, there's little. So yeah, put it through, tighten it up. When it gets around a little smaller than that, start putting a thimble just like that. Tighten it up all the way. It's ready to crimp. Get the crimpers. Put it in the 1.9 range. And crimp it right there. I don't really like these crimpers. The handle is terrible and it hurts my hands. But that's fishing right there. Crimp it down again. I'm sorry if you can't really see this in the video too good, but it's pretty hard. And yeah, remember to crimp it on the left all the way, but leave a little open just like that. And then you crimp it to the right and then in the middle. So yeah. Scoop this crimp down if it'll move, and then you put, I got my assistant here now.
Hi.
He's kind of gonna help me, and then you put your mono back through that other swivel.
Close up.
It'll go through, which is really bothering me right now. Whatever, I'm gonna try to push it out. There we go. Saw that. Okay. Gosh, this crimp is like crazy. Forget it. I'm keeping it that. Whatever. This is here. So then you crimp right there. That's the left side crimp. Use a table if you need something. Hard surface to press down with, just like right here.
That was the left crimp, then you do the right crimp.
Now the right side. Okay, then you do the middle. And you're done. And you trim this up. You can trim it up a little. You don't have to, but I do. That's a shark rig right there. So yeah, I'll just go through it right now. So here's the part where you attach your main line or to this swivel right here at the end of the mono, not the wire. The wire is where the hook is. So you attach your main line, and then you've got around 9 or 10 feet of this mono. And there. So I'm going to explain why I put two crimps. I'm going to steal the word from Black Tip H. He calls it insurance, and it's pretty much, that's exactly what it is. In case this crimp breaks, in case that crimp breaks, this one will stay, will still be on right here. Or in case this one breaks, this one will still be on, and it adds more strength to it. It basically doubles this main line up right here. So in case there is frayed by the shark past this wire and the hook and all that, this will definitely not break. And then yeah, so here's the thimble with the crimp right next to it, and then the other 400 pound swivel with the doubled number 15 wire with the knot, and then that's about 3 or 4 feet, 3.5 feet of that, and then the other knot attached to the hook. I think this is a 16-aught circle hook. If not 16-aught, it's an 18-aught. I'm not sure. I gotta ask Ryan from Infinity Fishing Team because they gave it to me. And again, yeah, thanks for showing me this rig, Ryan. And yeah, so see you guys. Peace.